Welcome back to Mission Control Houston. We've been talking a lot this week about the preparations that have been going on for the upcoming spacewalk, which is pretty much now upon us on Monday at 9:40 a.m. Central Time. Yuri Malenchenko and Gennady Padalka are going to be going out for the Russian EVA 31. And here to tell us a little bit more about that, we have with us Art Thomason. He's an EVA or spacewalk officer, and he's going to go over some of the tasks for that.
Good morning. Yeah, in Russian EVA 31, there's going to be three primary tasks. The first of those tasks is going to be to relocate a Strela from the DC-1 or the docking compartment 1 over to FGB. The reason they're doing this is DC-1 is eventually going to be replaced by a new module, so they're getting this Strela off of there. So they'll get that moved over to the FGB. From there, they'll head out to do a satellite deploy. And so that's actually a 20-pound steel ball that they're going to deploy from station, or jettison, if you will. And from that, they'll use that to verify math models at how things deorbit back into Earth. From there, their final task is they're going to be installing some protective shields on the outside of station. And so we have a video here that shows a little bit about what they're going to be doing on the EVA. You can see they'll come out of their airlock and then get right to work on the Strela. Now, this is actually the Strela that they're going to be moving during the EVA. They'll extend EV2 out to Strela 1 and then retract it.
And the Strelas are basically booms, kind of
yes.
Like our robotic arms, but not as
similar to our robotic arms. However, these are actually man-powered, so there's they crank with their hands to extend it and move it. So less overhead in operating it.
And they're just moving that out of the way so that they can eventually get take the piers off the station and replace it.
That's correct. And so that's what you're seeing here in this video. So they have two Strelas here. So they're extending one of the Strelas to capture the one that they're going to be removing. So it shows it here capturing that one. And then you'll see in just a moment they'll actually move it over back to the FGB. So here you see EV2 coming down. They're going to be working together to capture the Strela to be moved. Once it's secure, then they'll move it back over to the FGB.
And since we've done this once before, you think it'll go pretty straightforward? And
I think it'll be pretty straightforward. Both of these crew members have a lot of EVA experience, so I don't expect it to be a problem for them.
Okay. And then I guess, whenever they have anything to deploy, that always seems interesting to me.
It is. Yeah, and especially in this case, it's pretty neat because I think people are always interested in how things deorbit. There's small amounts of air, things like that are going to slow it down. So when you have a steel ball like this, it doesn't really matter the orientation. A lot of the things that we've jettisoned before, things like MLI, which is a thermal blanket, which those things, it really makes a difference on how it's oriented in space. So this does, the orientation doesn't matter as much.
Just like pitching a baseball, or
similar to that, they actually have a contraption that's going to release it, so that it's more a controlled release.
Okay, and it's to let the teams on the ground practice tracking. Is that?
That's right. So they'll track it, and it's going to be used to verify models and just better understand how things deorbit.
Okay.
So here you can see they're still at work on stowing that Strela or relocating it. Once they get it back into place on the FGB, they stow it so that it's out of the way. And from there, they translate back down the Strela. So you can see this is a telescoping piece of equipment that they can extend and retract by hand. So here you see Gennady riding back on the tip. They'll put this one back in place, Strela 1, and they'll secure that back to structure. Now here's you'll see this object flashing here as an external experiment. They're going to close that up. It's about the size of a laptop, if you will. So they'll close that up and bring it back inside. It's technically a get ahead, so they'll get it closed here, and then I guess we'll see how time's going on the EVA and potentially bring it in. Since it's right there, it's a get ahead of opportunity, if you will.
Sure. And the spacewalk's scheduled to last about 6.5 hours?
That's correct.
Here's the satellite.
That's correct. Yeah, you see the spherical satellite. As I mentioned, it was a 20-pound ball, so it's a pretty heavy thing when you have gravity. It's 21 inches in diameter.
Looks a little like a bowling ball.
Yeah, and so like some of the things that I mentioned earlier, thermal blankets that we've let go of before, then they don't have much mass, so they slow down quicker. This is a heavier object, so I think they're able to characterize how it deorbits a little bit better using something like this.
Okay.
And I think the metallic portion of it, too, makes it easier to track.
Sure, that makes sense.
So we saw that satellite get deployed, and then here some video on their final task. This is going to be installing a few protective shields. These shields protect from micrometeorite debris on the outside of station. So they're going to be installing these on the service module. You can see those being put into place right here.
And I know we kind of replace things like that fairly often, right? Is it just to make sure the station has the best protection possible?
That's correct.
Yeah.
Here you can see one of the other experiments called Biorisk that they're potentially bringing inside. Now, this is a get-ahead task. So this experiment, they get to bring it inside and find out scientific data that they collected during the course of the experiment. The final get-ahead here is to put struts on the ladder on the outside of docking compartment 1 just to stiffen that up. Eventually, when docking compartment 1 is replaced, they'll then install, they'll move that ladder over.
And that's a ladder that's used by spacewalkers when they're out these sorts of tasks.
Yeah, so right when they come out of the airlock, they climb out on that ladder.
Okay. All right. Well, so, this being a Russian spacewalk, how much does the U.S. flight control team here in Houston get involved?
For this one, we're definitely not involved in the same level we are for U.S. spacewalk. A U.S. spacewalk, we do the training on the ground, we write the procedures, and then when the crew is performing the task, we're walking them through step by step and helping them with any problems that they run into. For the Russian EVA, they are borrowing a few of our U.S. tools. One of those is the wireless video system, so it's basically a video camera that's mounted to the crew's helmet. So for that, now you'll get to see the point of view of the crew member and watch them work, see what they're seeing. So they're borrowing that tool. They're also borrowing a few tethers that we have.
Okay.
So we're involved with getting those over to them, making sure they're configured correctly for them. We're also following along for the spacewalk. We definitely don't have control of what's going on, but we're watching, and for our U.S. systems, as well as things that are going to affect the wireless video system, we make sure that all the proper inhibits are in place, things are powered down, things that may interfere with the wireless video system. We are involved, but on a much smaller scale.
Well, I know NASA TV viewers are always glad to know that there's going to be helmet camera views.
Yes.
Okay. Well, and I know they've been spending pretty much all week getting ready for it, and we're even getting ready already for the U.S. spacewalk that's coming up at the end of the month. I think today, though, they were trying on their Orlons, doing some final checks and making sure they were fitting right and everything.
Yeah, that's correct. It's kind of a dress rehearsal, if you will, making sure that the suit fits correctly. They can make last-minute adjustments, so they don't have to take the time to do that on the day of the spacewalk. They get to translate around a little bit inside their airlock to make sure that they're comfortable in the suit, get a little bit of practice before the real day.
Okay. So I think everything's gone smoothly so far in all the preparations, though.
Yes.
So we should be ready to go on Monday, 9:40 a.m. Central Time.
That's correct.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming and talking with us about it. We'll be watching on Monday.
Thank you.